News is brought to you by Dawa Khana, Rehari, Chungi and Gandhi Nagar, Jammu. Northern Command Army Commander Lieutenant General Yogesh Kumar Joshi on Thursday presented gallantry as well as distinguished service awards to officers, junior commissioned officers, soldiers and next of kin of the martyrs in a solemn investiture ceremony at Udhampur. During the ceremony, the Army Commander presented 5 Bhartu Sena medals and 73 Sena medals to the brave soldiers of the Army. 8 of these awardees were conferred the award posthumously and given to the next of kin. Union Minister of State for Power and New and Renewable Energy R.K. Singh and Lieutenant Governor Girish Chandra Murmu on Wednesday chaired a high-level meeting at the Civil Secretariat to review the power and renewable energy scenario in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir and discuss the modalities for strengthening the power sector in J&K. During the meeting, the Union MOS for Power highlighted that the mission of the Union Government is to provide 24/7 power to all the districts of UT of J&K within the next 2 years. Jammu and Kashmir administration suspended 40 teachers of different schools in South Kashmir district of Kulgam who were found absent from duty. Chief Education Officer and other officers of the Education Department inspected various schools in Kulgam district following information that majority teachers have not attended their duties when educational institutions reopened on Monday after winter vacation. 40 teachers were found absent during the inspection. The absentees were suspended besides show cause notice has been issued against them. Khidmat Center Association staged protest demanding implementation of job policy by J&K Bank. The protest entered 67th day on Monday alleging that J&K Bank totally failed in keeping promises for recruitment, owing to which 1,204 families are suffering. With about a month left for Tulip Festival in Srinagar, people associated with tourism industry are hopeful that visitors from across the world would throng in large numbers to see Asia's largest tulip garden, which will have 13 lakh flowers of 55 varieties in its lap on the banks of world-famous Dal Lake. The garden usually opens in the last week of March or first week of April, depending on the weather. The two-day annual book fair 2020, which was organized by Directorate of School Education Jammu in conjunction with State Institute of Education at Teachers Bhavan Gandhinagar Jammu, concluded today. Books related to at least 30 different disciplines and journal books ranging from textbooks, reference books, books on politics, religion, literature, dance, music and various other streams were displayed at the fair. Apple Kids Seni Colony celebrated its annual day function amidst great fanfare with full gusto and enthusiasm today. Professor Manoj Dar, Vice Chancellor, University of Jammu, was the chief guest on the occasion, who convened his good wishes for the management, students and staff for the excellent work. The Agriculture Department has organized 3 days visit for around 70 farmers of Agriculture Subdivision Prano to Chinani and Sud Mahadev areas of Udhampur district to learn new technologies introduced in the field of farming, especially vegetable growers. The team of farmers was flagged off by DDC Dora Dr. Sagar D. Doifode. Over 32,000 candidates appeared in 12th class examination of summer zone that commenced today. The examination was conducted peacefully with no report of untoward incident. All arrangements have been put in place made for the smooth conduct of annual board examinations. The third edition of Pandit Premnath Dogra Memorial Gold Cup football tournament will be organized by the State Sports Council from 2nd March to 12th March 2020. On the last day, that is Nirvan Divas of the great leader, an avid sportsman tributes will be paid to him. District Police Ramban organized a police public meeting at Bani Hall on Wednesday. BDC chairpersons, sarpanchs, panches and prominent citizens from Bani Hall area attended the meeting. On the occasion, the senior citizens, member of civil society and PRIs welcomed SSP Ramban Haseeb ul Rahman on his maiden visit to Bani Hall. The Indian government government has evacuated a total of 195 Indians and 41 foreign nationals from the coronavirus-hit Chinese city of Wuhan and quarantined cruise ship Diamond Princess, the Ministry of External Affairs said on Thursday. Till date, a total of 842 Indians and 48 foreign nationals have been evacuated from China and Japan. Congress President Sonia Gandhi on Thursday lashed out at Delhi government and centre, accusing them of being mute spectators as violence continued unabated in northeast Delhi. She once again demanded the dismissal of Union Home Minister Amit Shah. Gandhi led a delegation of senior Congress leaders and met President Ram Nath Kovind to seek normalcy and peace in violence-hit Delhi. Deputy Commissioner O.P. Bhagat on Wednesday inaugurated district-level centre for women established under a centrally sponsored scheme. The Government of India has launched Mahila Shakti Kendra scheme to provide one-stop convergence support services for empowering rural women with opportunities for skill development, employment, digital literacy, health and nutrition. The security of the strategic Srinagar International Airport in Kashmir was taken over by the Central Industrial Security Force 6 weeks after a deputy superintendent of police posted there was caught ferrying terrorists out of the valley. The CISF has deployed over 500 personnel to guard the premises, which include frisking at the gate followed by comprehensive search ahead of boarding a flight. An army jawan died after he fell into a deep gorge following an avalanche in Gurez sector along the line of control in Jammu and Kashmir. The army on Thursday paid tributes to Sepoy Colonel Singh at the Badami Bagh cantonment. With northeast Delhi on the edge with 35 dead and over 200 injured after 4 straight days of brutal violence over the citizenship law, 130 people have been arrested so far. Two special investigation teams of Delhi Police Crime Branch will probe northeast Delhi riots. Delhi Police announced the formation of the SITS headed by Deputy Commissioner of Police rank official on Thursday evening.